I'm ready to start adding the illusion of muscles into my sculpture. And this is a great place to begin the fine concept sculpting for your land animal, because these muscular structures are going to inform a lot of our sculpture itself. So I've just smoothed out my mesh. This has just basically been remeshed from the blockout stage that we saw before, and I've just spent a couple minutes smoothing out all the faceted edges, and this is what we get. Nothing too fancy here. It's pretty straightforward. But now I'm ready to go in and start adding the illusion of some really important muscle groups. The way I like to work, and this is just me, is that I like to start from the back and work my way towards the front itself, being mindful of how some of these muscle structures are going to influence each other. Now, as we go through this, if you remember from our earlier conversation about anatomy, there's some important ideas in here that we're looking to capture. Specifically, I want to make sure in the back here that I'm capturing the sweeping motion of muscles coming from the rear to terminate right about in here on the bear's knee. In addition, for the front part, remember the elbow's back here, right? And there's that wonderful V-shaped pattern of muscles coming from the neck down here. There's another group that goes up this way. And then there's a whole series of muscles that terminate on the elbow itself. You should be mindful of that. I love these little drawing apps, these annotation tools, because we can very quickly go in and start to plot and plan how all of this stuff is going to work. I like to do this. I'm using an app called Presentify, which allows me to sculpt on top of my environment. Now, if you don't have this app, there's some great alternatives inside of Blender itself, and they're called the annotation tools. And the annotation tools, it's way down at the bottom of your toolbar. I'm sorry, I'm blocking the icon at the moment because it really is the last one in our sculpting toolbar. It's the one that looks like a pencil. And the annotation tools, as one might imagine, allows us to draw a simple line on the model itself. Now, the cool thing about the annotation tools, if you go up here to the top, there's a big button that says Note, and I want to make the thickness value quite a bit bigger. Let's change the color to that lovely pink. And we can fundamentally do the exact same thing. This is in 3D, by the way. We can fundamentally do the exact same thing as I was doing with Presentify. I can go in and kind of remind myself, you know, I want the forms to be kind of going like this. You know, I want some ideas, or I want some lines and the idea of a muscle coming down this way. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Here's that V-shaped muscle coming off the top of the shoulder blade. Okay, let me make the thickness a little bit bigger so you guys at home can see what I'm doing. And I'll also make the color just a real fun pink. So the exact same thing. When you want to get rid of the annotations, if you like, just go back up to the annotation toolbar. And I always click on this little drop-down menu that says Note. And we can just hit the minus sign and those annotations go away. Okay, just a quick little tip to make you help you visualize where you want these structures to go. Now let's start the rear here. You can use whatever tools that you like to start establishing the structure. I find that the clay and the clay strips tool do a fantastic job of quickly blocking out some detail inside of the mesh itself. So it's this one here, this is clay strips, and its neighbor to the left here is clay. As you can see, clay is just gonna allow us to go in and just kind of throw down some nice lumpy forms. Clay strips, it's a little bit more angular. Yeah, see how it's a little bit more blocky with its stroke. So you find one that works for you. There's no wrong way of doing this. The goal here is just to be able to very quickly go in and start creating some mass. And the mass that's informed by our muscle groups. Excuse me, I misspoke. So I know that I wanna have some muscles come in here, okay? And I'm just kind of plotting and planning right now. I'm not doing a tremendous amount of sculpting work, okay? And the cool thing about clay strips is that it almost kind of looks like muscles to begin with. So it's a great way to begin our sculpting process. Just throw down the illusion of some muscles. I know that I'm gonna have a muscle connecting the knee to the ankle down there, okay? We're not trying to sculpt in all the muscles, but we are trying to figure out where the landmarks of those muscles are so that we can increase the mass in those areas to suggest that the muscles are in fact there. So that's a good one to start with. Now that we have an idea of where they are, let's smooth some of them out. Just trying to create some mass here. Up and down movements are really good. Try to find a termination spot. Of course, naturally, I'm modeling in symmetry. which is helpful because then we can kind of see how these muscles are going to terminate over the back of the bear. Something like that. Yeah, there we go. Of course, there's going to be a muscle that comes down the back of the knee, or the back of the knee, and of course, the back of the calf as well. It's going to have its own muscle. Something like this. Now, I apologize if this is real subtle on your screen. I'm used to working in small, subtle strokes, excuse me. So I'll over-accentuate this just to kind of prove it, and or not prove it, but just to showcase it to you guys. But this is a good place to begin. I'm just trying to block out some mass. Now, if you'd like, and this is a great thing to modify your workflow with, don't forget, if you hit the control key while you stroke with your cursor, it's gonna push in, okay? So I'm gonna take away, I'm doing some subtractive sculpting now, just to start blocking out some planes. Holding down the shift key just to kind of smooth some of this out. It's getting a little lumpy, but now we're starting to get some mass in here. Now we're starting to get some sculptural planes that's informing my understanding of it. Yeah, and if you look real carefully, let's change our matte cap to a nice, let's do the red one. Yeah, because I think it's a little bit easier. Check it out, and this is what I'm talking about. This is the bee's knees, as they say. Check it out, right there. Okay, boom. Now we're starting to get a plane break. This right here is what we are after. That plane break is starting to suggest that there's a gigantic muscle in there, and I like that. That's starting to feel a little bit more realistic, okay? It's starting to feel and look like something that we're used to seeing. Now, I have some additional work in here that I need to do on this. I want to start creating the illusion that there's a big muscle here. Get a nice little plane break here. But we can't forget about all of this jazz. And this is where it kind of got a little over-adjusted during that remesh prep that I had before. It's getting a little too muscular for me at the moment. We don't want this to be, you know, Hulk Bear, where everything is just super, super muscular. But we can smooth it out and then use maybe like the inflate tool to start softly transitioning between some of these forms. I'm a little too crazy with it. Yeah, I'm liking that. That's a good place to go. If you look here, I like this plane break that we're getting in the back. It's gigantic at the moment. Let's grab the move brush and start getting some of that mass back that we saw before. You don't have to use the move brush. I like the move brush. It works for me, but ultimately, at the end of the day, you can use the push tool as well and smooth some of that out. Yeah, we're getting some of that mass back. Now, this is one of the reasons why I wanted to push the belly up when I was sculpting earlier. So I can bring this down. My brush is a little bit too small. Make it a little bit bigger. There we go. Let's smooth it out. Kind of get a little lumpy here. I'm not quite nailing the shape that I'm after. It's a great thing about sculpting. You can experiment with something. You can try it. And then if you mess up, it's okay. Pobody's nerfic, as they say, right? We can either smooth it out. Yeah, I'm going to see how I'm moving those two islands together, those two parts together, and I'm starting to create, I went a little too far, a little too angular, starting to create that natural crease and fold. I wouldn't have been able to do that if the belly and the arm, or excuse me, the leg of the bear were remeshed like they were initially. Now I can very quickly control that transition. Yeah, all right, that's getting there. I still got a lot of work in there that I need to do, but we're starting to get there. We're starting to get there, slowly but surely. Last thing I want to talk about real fast is just the neck when it comes to establishing muscles. Because as we saw in the previous example or the previous reference image, is that neck muscle is super important for all of our large animals. Let's go in, start blocking it out a little bit. I've gone back into clay strips, make my brush a little bit smaller. And let's start prototyping where all these muscles need to go. As a reminder, there's going to be a muscle that comes down here. Big muscle group, okay? And there's also another one that's going to make that V going up this way. Start to block that out pretty quickly. You can start to see where those plane breaks are going to live. The muscle is going to help define where the shape changes rapidly. It's a good place to go. It doesn't have to be a hard edge like I had just there, but we can smooth it out and we can make a little bit more. Yeah, because now it looks like there's starting to be a muscle in here. There's something that's bulging from underneath the skin that's pushing and changing the mass of the character right in that area. Yeah, that's not so bad. We're getting there. We'll smooth out some of those shapes. You'll find that when I start sculpting, and as you watch me, I like to be additive as much as I can. There we go. We'll get in close. Here's the elbow in the back. That's where the elbow is going to go. So we're going to have another muscle group coming down this way. Coming down this way. Yeah. I'm just going to really crank that muscle. I'm going to do the same for the knee. The knee is a little bit more kind of soft and cuddly on a bear, but it's something to kind of highlight. It's helpful for you as the sculptor to know where those plane breaks are. Yeah, that's better. Kind of gives you a visual landmark to plan with as you start to lay down these mass shapes. And don't forget about the calf. The calf has a pretty big muscle. I did a nice job establishing that calf with my simple shapes. Let's smooth some of this out, and we'll see what we get. Yeah, that's starting to look a little bit better. I'm starting to get the plane break in the front that I'm looking for. I'm going to really accentuate and drive it home so you guys can see what I'm after. See how it breaks right there? That plane break is important because now it gives us the opportunity to start crafting some neck muscles that come down here. Yeah. Yes, that's starting to work. I'm liking that. I'm liking that. Now, bears are kind of fluffy. Bears hold a lot of weight in their appendages. So, like I said, we're not trying to be super ripped here with all of our muscle structures, but they really do help us block out some pretty big shapes here. And of course, you add, and then you can smooth them out a little bit too. But be mindful of it. Be informed by our reference so that when it comes time to sculpting this, there's a layer of believability in here that our audience can hang on to when they're looking at your sculpture. It's also gonna make you a really efficient sculpture because now you're no longer just kind of plotting out things wherever you want. There's at least a little bit of a foundation from our reference and our research that will lead our decision-making process. And then once we have things kind of working, once the sculpture is kind of rocking and rolling the way we want it to, then we can start layering on our own interpretation of what this object is supposed to look like and from what we see in our imagination. But these muscle groups go a long, long way in helping us understand how this bear is fundamentally going to be sculpted to layer on that layer of believability.